So welcome back, guys, to another tutorial video. This is going to be the second part of this one. The first half annotations on the screen. Now, if you want to go and check that out, please do. That is basically on how to build the actual shell. But if you've done that, let's crack on and do this now. So, as you finish the shell here, we're going to be doing the roofing this episode and various different other things. But as you can see, it is looking pretty damn swanky. Obviously, if you have joined the video, welcome. But if you haven't, please go and check out number one, because it does show you how to build these. As well, guys, if you're new to this as well, these four here in particular will be built eventually. Castle is already done as a video in the channel if you want to go check that out. Pretty damn cool, I must say so, and a lot of detail and a lot of time spent on that. Well, let's crack on with this video. So as you can see, the roofing is pretty much there and done. So what we're going to be doing now is choosing a slightly darker color. This is going to be for your flooring and for start of your roof. So if we go in, let's do the flooring as a start. As you can say, guys, all I said is at the beginning, obviously make sure you have your torches up to see what you are doing. And also as well, this episode, we're going to be doing the stairs, which we just saw here. So the easiest thing to do with the stairs, is all I can say, is leave the oak wood here. Leave the oak wood here. Obviously, you can see this is a nice little walkway in between here. We're just going to cut this off and make it look official. So the stairs are actually going to run along this wall here. So you can take these blocks out as well, obviously, because the circle is done. And we're going to have quite a large stairs. And you're probably thinking, Jesus, that is an awful large stairs. Remember, guys, only going up to the second layer. So to be honest, it's not going to be that big in itself. So place down your oak blocks as well, just to make it look swanky. Come back around the other side and just make a small cut through into the top half of your next level as well. So obviously, if we can get over there. Make sure the stairs are fully functioning as well on either sides, on all points. As you can see, they are up, down. Yeah, brilliant. So from there, carry on putting your steps down. Oh. Hello, there we go. And there we go, the stairs up to the second floor. You can actually flake off a next layer on this one as well, which I think I will do as well. Because I'm not too particularly happy with that. So as you can see, marvellous looking, pretty damn good. And you can actually build this back up with oak, just to conceal those stairs as well. It's entirely up to you. There we go. I'm going to do it like that. Screw it. Make it look a little bit more fancy. Can I get in there and do it as well? I can. You can't see it, but the textures are there, so that's all good. So, as well, you can build this back up as well. It's entirely up to you. Just to make it look sort of somewhat concealed. This is going to be awkward. Yeah, I can do it from this side, can I? Yeah, surely. Okay, I'm going to build this along then. If it's not going to let me do it. There we go. Just to make it look somewhat professional. There we go. I think that looks pretty doody. As you can see, it's all concealed. It's quite nice on either sides as well. Normally, when you do stairs, they look kind of shit. And I don't know why, but they normally just do. So see there. You also as well, guys, another idea as well. I'm not going to do it in this video, but just a little idea. Could actually have an underground here. You could dig a little hole or something that goes into this, or a piston door to go down into a hole, just to hide all your goodies and hide your stash. So I'm going to remove the majority of this now, and I'm actually going to do the flooring. So as well, just take away all the dirt. Nice and simple. As well, just take all of this out. As well, guys, you could choose anything that you wanted to choose. It's entirely up to you. The blocks that I've just chosen are corresponding to the thumbnail and for my tutorial, but you can change these to whatever you like. It is entirely up to you. You don't have to choose them. You could even make this out of freaking gold if you wanted to, or cobblestone, or something in particular like that. It's entirely up to you. But I've chosen these blocks because I think, A, they work really nice with each other, and B, it's just sort of that classic, classy sort of house look. So, but it's entirely up to you on what sort of variation you do with yourself. I do apologize as well for the clicking. I'm using a condenser mic, so it pretty much just picks up anything. It would even pick up the freaking doorbell or a door knocking. So just as well, there is nobody here to pick that up. So as you can see, I don't know why, but just the light and the dark correspondent really don't clash that much. I think they look kind of sleek with that on. Same thing on this one as well. Obviously, the upper layer has a different flooring. You can change this, but for me, I've just kept it like that. It's just a little bit lighter. because obviously the light inside of the house is going to be pouring through the windows. Can do windows downstairs as well, which we're going to do in the detail to finalize, but obviously I did the windows upstairs for starters, purely because I needed them to be there before I made any drastic moves on top of that as well. You can actually build those windows down into the next layer as well, which we'll do, and do it like that. So if you obviously have just come into sort of the second part of this video and you just want a quick build, then pretty much just showing you straight off the bat how to do those windows and how to sculpt your little bit there. Oh dear, let me go put that back. Yeah, it is getting pretty darn quick at this, not gonna lie. But obviously guys, if you want to see any of the other builds, if they aren't done yet, then just hold up if you're watching this as soon as it's come out. But if not, if you've left this for a couple of weeks, or you know, in the future you've seen this, then the 9 times out of 10 the majority of the other builds are done. Please go and check those out, they're pretty darn cool. I'm happy with that. Not going to reveal anything just yet, I'm just going to leave them to come out, but we're finalizing a review of all the stuff that we've built just generally after the time that they have been done. So yeah, that'll be pretty damn cool. So obviously everything is done. I've left this here because I don't know, it just looks kind of nice. So you probably won't be able to see it, but the stairs is done there, different flooring upside there as well. What we're going to do is actually going to sort of crack on by doing this bit as well. So you can actually just take this bit out. And as you can see, it's kind of a full flesh window in itself, which is quite nice because that flooring bumps it back as well. And yeah, it's really kind of cool. So I'm going to obviously leave that one there. I might take out this one as here. Just the two on that one as well, and two on this one. I want to go three high on that. I don't know, it just doesn't... I'm not comfortable with doing three high on that in the same. These don't have to line up, guys. You can just pretty much just do what you want. That is going to be a little bit awkward, so I'm going to go two on this side and then two on this side. There we go. Yeah, not too bad. So let's crack on with the roofing now. So obviously you want that darker shade. You want to come in one and then up one, and then you can follow this around. Pretty nice and simple. Show you a little trick as well, obviously, to make the roof look less bulkier. And then after that, you just want to pretty much build around. Now, usually I wouldn't actually do this because 9 times out of 10, I'll literally say something for you, I'll set something for you to do, like the Castle Detroit, as it was such a big build. And then I'll come back to it when it's done, literally, and sort of like, it would look like I've built so much in about a second, which I actually haven't. It was very time consuming. I didn't want to record the whole thing purely because we would have been here the whole freaking day. I'm not even joking, that build is ludicrous. That build is absolutely silly. Bits like this as well on the stick, sort of the head or the stem of the hallway, is a little bit difficult when you come to roofing as well. I'll show you a little trick when we get to that as well. But just make sure they all connect like so. And then after that as well, you literally want to build another layer. Now, personally, what I like to do is just connect it off and seal it all off like so, because what happens then is that you can section off slight different variations of things. For example, like this building here, we'll go around just in this circle, and then on the next half we'll go around on the other circle. So as you can see, we just build up one circle like so. This was originally a circle, so took back to the point of having a bit of clay and then molding it into the specific thing that you want. So as you can see, if we come all the way along here, we can build this layer up as well, and then build the other circle, and then that, obviously that stem for that hallway, and we can branch it out and build it and mold it to how we want it. As you can see, not going on to the other side just yet, literally just going to be building this rooftop. See, it's not a massive roof because it is actually all going to connect pretty damn quickly and pretty damn soon. Obviously I'm going to show you how to take away the bulking of the roof, but as you can see guys, don't worry about it looking too bad at the moment. Obviously when it comes to the detailing video, it's going to be a lot of different things as well. So as you can see, this one connects, obviously not this little bit just yet. It's going to be one more sort of layer, I think, maybe. Yeah, one more layer, which is going to be a four block like so. Zoom out, it looks okay at the moment, not too shabby, but we're going to be branching out and bulking out with our slabs. And these can be the same color or different colors, it's entirely up to you. But for me, I don't know, I'm going to switch it up a little bit. I'm going to be using something slightly different. But again, it's entirely up to you how you want to be doing it. I might choose the same color yet. I'm very indecisive when it comes to these builds. I want to try and look at it as the best I can, because obviously you've clicked the thumbnail for a reason. You want to know how to build it. If it looked like shit, then you wouldn't want to build it. End of, pretty much. Gonna be quite transparent on that. So let's carry on. Nearly done this circle. This is only a small circle comparison to that one, obviously, because that was a bigger circle. And it's going to be a little bit hard. There we go. One block like so. Now, you can actually leave the middle. It's entirely up to you, but I'm not going to because it's just going to look freaking weird if we do. So, I don't know what I'm going to do here. Probably some... probably build it up another layer. Not entirely too sure just yet. But that will come down to the slabs. Now, I'm actually going to switch my mind out here. I'm going to actually use some normal slabs which correspond to the roofing itself. You don't have to do this. It's entirely up to you. I'm going to find that there. Is that the same one? That is. Let's go to the slabs. And what you're going to pretty much be doing is come one out on the brown. Just come all the way out on the brown. Actually, no. Deduct that. Screw that. Screw that. Don't worry. I've got another idea which will save you time and confusion. Come out one on the sides of the brown. I'll show you why in a minute. Come all the way out. Yeah, don't connect these as well, guys. Please make sure you do not connect these. Because obviously the roof has that rigid effect then. And if they're connected, it just looks freaking weird. But only connect the ones when you're actually making the roof itself. I'll show you a little trick that's time-consuming. Not time-consuming. Saves you from being time-consumed. God, that could have got awkward. And obviously it's going to flesh out a lot more of the roofing as well. So it stands out and it actually has that roof effect instead of just a shitload of blocks. So otherwise it would just look freaking weird. No, let's carry on doing this. One in there, one in there. Actually, one along there. Almost missed that one then. Almost there. But as I say, guys, I don't want to sort of skip all this tutorial, all this video, just to miss out. So as you can see, it looks a lot better just generally. You can leave it like that, but for me, I'm not. I'm actually going to carry on doing this. So, yeah, I regret that. Let's do one layer on that as well. I think, let's have a little look. One layering on all of that. Yeah, we should be alright. Okay. So, what I'm going to be doing is putting one in each corner on the builds ups as well. If you get confused on this as well, just don't do it just yet. But you can just pretty much follow it all the way around. It's exactly the same as we did on the roofing of this side. You just pretty much want to just do it all the way around on the other sides as well. Now this can get a little bit confusing to the eye. But obviously I'm just going to do it and then I'm just going to show you the results at the end as well, guys. You don't have to have this roofing. It's entirely up to you. At the end of the day, it's your freaking roof. All it is just literally a tutorial slash sort of build idea. But as I say, you don't have to have it. So it's entirely up to you how you want to do it. Now, the stem of the roof will actually look a little bit more bulky as well. I don't know why, even though we've put more blocks onto the... Why have I done that? Aesthetics of this roof. So... gonna look a little bit weird. All the way around here. You'll see the middle in a minute, I'll show you. Just cover all of these other ones. So you gotta cover them first, but obviously you would have got a little bit confused with the thing. So we're also gonna come around here. I'm not gonna do them ones, just the corners. I need it the most. Not these ones either. I suppose you could do these ones maybe. I don't like them ones. As well, guys, as you can see, very, very tricky to the eye. I'm not going to lie. But it's just in each of the corners, to be honest. So you've done this side, done this side. Done majority of this bit up here. That's probably... Whoa. Down on there, there we go, I'm gonna get out of that, fuck it. Make this come down like so. Okay, that's looking a-okay to be honest. There's a roof. Same thing on this one as well. Come along just to flush it out a little bit. And then I'm gonna leave that like that. So that's pretty much what we want to be going for. You know, a variation of roof, guys, is talips, but you can see the difference between the two. Obviously I've done this little section here, but obviously the top half here is totally different. As you can see, it just gives it a nice flair, and as well, the back or the neck of the stem doesn't actually look that sort of distorted now, or sort of that out of place. I don't know why, but bulking up these sides, or bulking up just generally roofing, I don't know, it just makes it look a lot better. It's weird. It is really weird, but it does work, so I'm not going to argue. Same thing on these ones as well, just in the corners. It's all about those corners. See a corner as well. make sure to fill it. I think we're all good on that one as well. But thing on this one as well, you can actually sort of build a stem all the way along, maybe, I don't know. Let's have a look, see what it looks like. No, I'm happy with that. That looks alright. Maybe come a block along. Maybe come blocks along, let's say. It's alright. Just to bulk it out a little bit. Yeah, I'm happy with that. So boom. That's the roofing on that one. We'll have a quick little tour around as well. Have a little look. We have a look at that as well. Remember, guys, in the corners you can see sort of like that ridge effect. Really quite nice as well. You can build this as high as you like. But again, entirely up to you how you want to do this. I'm going to leave this bit flat just because it looks more modern. Not too sure about these bits here, though. Ooh. Good lord, no. Let's leave those bits like so. Change that up a little bit. There we go. So yeah, that's been the roofing on this episode. Obviously, if you did enjoy, make sure to hit me another like in the comment. But remember, guys, fix those corners as well. Go back and tweak it as well. You can even come in slightly more, and you can even sort of play around with this bit here, a little bit here. You know, it's entirely up to you how you want to have it. You know, at the end of the day, it's your house. All it is just tips, guys, and tutorials. But if you're following along, that is pretty much how you do it. In each corner, just plug a little slab in, and it just thicks out and makes it look a lot more prosthetically nice and pleasing to the eye. Otherwise it just look blocky as hell and look damn shit. So on the next episode, what we've got to do is the detailing the house. I won't do a lot of that. I won't be doing beds. It'll be mainly windows, doors, things and little ideas and trinkets you can put actually in the house, and maybe tweaking the shell ever so slightly. But obviously, if you're finished up with that one and you don't want to watch the detailing, that has been pretty much the build itself. But if you have, stay tuned for the build, which is going to be part 3. It's going to be detailing. But as always, guys, Killer Kev here, and Killer Kev out.